एंड एवरेज इज द वैल्यू विच बेस्ट डिफाइंस अ सेट. इट्स ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द मेजर ऑफ सेंट्रल टेंडेंसी. There are three different types of averages. Mean, which is just the regular average we use, that's summation upon n. Then we have a median. Median is basically the middle value. And then we have mode, which is the highest frequency, the value with the highest frequency. Or you can say the most frequent value. Let's begin with the mean. Mean of a set is denoted by x bar. It's a very simple concept. You will have a data set. For instance, the data set is 2, 3, 5, 10, 12, and 13. So these are 6 data values you have. You have to find the mean of this set. So you'll find the sum, which is 2 plus 3 plus 5 plus 10 plus 12 plus 13 upon 6. Now this sum is 5 plus 5, 10, 20, 32, 45. So the average is 45 upon 6. Simplified would be 15 upon 2 or 7.5. This is the mean of this set. Let's say the set we have is 3, 4, 7, 8, and 5, for instance. If you have to find the average, the mean of this data set, just add these values. That's 3 plus 4 plus 7 plus 8 plus 5 upon 5. Because now there are 5 data values. So the sum would be 7 plus 7, 14, 14 plus 8, 22, 22 plus 5, 27, 27 by 5, which is 5.4. Now the next concept is basically finding the data value when you have the mean. For instance, I tell you that the average or the mean of 5 data values is 6.2, for instance, and I give you 4 data values. Let's say the 4 data values are 10, 5, 8, 12. They're saying now find the 5th data value. Let's just call this x for now. So this is what I have to find. I have the 4 data values. I have the average of the 5 values. Using this information, I have to find the unknown, which is x, the 5th data value. So the idea is exactly the same as before. You will still have to use the same relationship, which is sum upon n equals mean. So that's 10 plus 5 plus 8 plus 12 plus x upon 5, which is equal to 6.2. Now first we can cross multiply 6.2 into 5. This will be 31. Now, if you add the numerator, that's 15 plus 8. In fact, let's take 15 plus 20, 35. 35 plus x. So 35 plus x is 31. Hence, x is minus 4. So it's the same concept. We're just going backwards to the data value. Now we have a case where after her third test, her average score is 88. So basically there were 3 tests and the average of those 3 tests came out to be 88. Now the question is, what score does she need to get on her fourth test in order to have a final average of 90? Now the difference here as compared to the previous example is I do not have the first three scores. Instead, I have the average of those scores. So what I can do first is I can find the sum of scores in the first three tests. X bar is sum upon n. So I can also say that sum is just x bar into n. Using this relationship, I can find the sum of the first three scores. I know the average is 88. So 88 times 3 is the sum in the first three tests, which is 264. Now, how this is 264? Let's see. 88 into 3 is what we have to find. What you can do is, since we don't have calculators, what you can do is you can break this up into 80 plus 8 times 3. Now just open the bracket. That's 3 times 80, which is 240, and 3 times 8, which is 24. So 240 plus 24 is how I get 264. Now this is what I know about the first three tests. What I have to find is the score on the fourth test such that the average is 90. Now the average has to be 90. Which is again summation upon n. Now n is 4 because we have the average of 4 tests. The sum is 264 plus the 4th test, which we have to compute. Right? So just solve this for x. What you get is 264 plus x equals 90 times 4, which is 360. Hence x is 360 minus 264, which is 96. So this is the score she needs on her fourth test to get an average of 90. Now if you don't know how to compute this, 360 minus 264, you can say this is just 260 plus 4. If you open the bracket, that's 360 minus 260 minus 4. 360 minus 260 is 100, 100 minus 4 is 96. You can do this mentally as well, but in case you struggle with numbers, you can always split a number into multiple numbers just to make calculation easier. Now the next concept we have is called the combined average or the weighted average. It's a very simple concept. It just says if you have two different sets, for instance, there's a set A which has an average of 5, for instance, and number of observations in A are 7, and there is a set B with an average of 6 and number of observations equals 8. So what we have to find is the combined average, which is the average of all these 15 observations. So total number of observations is 15. I have to find the average, which is summation upon n. N here is 15, 8 plus 7. But to find the sum, I'll first have to find the individual sums. So if I start off with sum of observations in set A, let's say SA, that would be 5 into 7, which is 35. Because X bar A is sum of A upon NA. So if I have to find sum, I can just cross multiply the mean and number of observations, which gives me 35. Similarly, for sum of B, same concept, I'll have to multiply the mean, which is 6, by number of observations, which is 8. That's 48. Now, once you have the individual sums, the combined sum would be, let's say SC is for combined sum, that would be 35 plus 48. 35 plus 48 would be 83. 83 is the combined sum, hence the average is 83 upon 15. Now this cannot be simplified further, so you can keep the answer in this form. It depends on the options you have. Let's take one more example. Now what we have to find is the average of the entire fundraiser, in which 25 people donated $50 on average. and 15 people donated $100 on average. So to find the combined average, what I have to do is I have to find the combined sum and the combined number of observations. Combined number of observations is very simple. That's basically 25 plus 15. That's 40. So total 40 people contributed. So that's the number of observations. I also have to find the combined sum. So if I talk about those who donated 50, that made a total of 25 times 50. This is the total donation from these 25 people. And for those who donated 100 on average, that makes a total of 15 times 100. What we need is a combined sum. So I'll just add these values. That would give me the combined sum of donations, total donations, upon total number of people who donated is the average of the entire fundraiser. Now the fraction simplifies to the average. The answer to this fraction is the average. So if I open the bracket, this is 1250. 15 times 100 is 1500 upon 40. That's basically 2750 upon 40. Now this can be simplified further. So if I first divide both sides by 10, then you have to divide 275 by 4. What you can do is, you can first divide both sides by 2. If I divide both sides by 2, I get 137.5 upon 2. Further dividing this by 2, I get 68.75. This is the average of the entire fundraiser. Now the next average we have is the median. Median, like I said, is the middle value. The only thing you have to be careful about is arranging the set. For instance, the set you have is 2, 3, 5, 4, 7. For instance. Now if you look at the set, this is not sorted. So whenever you have to find the median, first sort the data. If I sort this data, what I get is 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. Now the median value is going to be the middle value after sorting the data, which is clearly 4 in this case. So median is 4. There is a formula to find the median position. Median position of any set can be obtained by n plus 1 upon 2, where n is the number of data values. If I apply the formula here, the data values in this set are 5. There are 5 data values. So median position should be 5 plus 1 upon 2, which is 3. So I can count in the ascending order or descending order, which means I can start counting from this end or this end. I will end up at 4 at the third position. This will not give me the median, but the median position only. So I'll have to see which value I have at this position, which in this case is 4. Now let's say the set we have is 2, 3, 7, 9, 11, 15, 18, for instance. Now if you look at the data values, these are sorted. They are in ascending order. So I have to find the median, which is again the middle value. So I'll count the data values. There are 7 data values. So the median position is going to be 7 plus 1 upon 2, which is 4th. So the 4th value is the median value. You can count in ascending or descending order. You will land at 9. This is the 4th value from either sides. So the median value is 9. Now let's say the next set we have is 2, 4, 7, 6, 3, 8. So clearly this is not sorted. First I'll have to sort the data. When I sort this data, I get 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. I have to find the median of this data set. Again, there are 6 data values, so the median position would be 6 plus 1 upon 2, which is 3.5th. So clearly there is not going to be any 3.5th value in the set. So what this actually means is you have to take the average of the third and the fourth value. 3.5 basically lies between 3 and 4. It's right midway between 3 and 4. So that is the idea. To find the 3.5th value, I'll just take the average of the fourth, 4 and 6, which is 4 plus 6, 10, 10 upon 2, which is 5. So the median value is 5 for this set. So always remember, if you have the median position in terms of decimal, it actually means it's the average of the two boundaries jinke beech mein wo lie karta hai. If 3.5, the boundaries are 3 and 4. 3.5 lies between 3 and 4. So I'll take the average of the third and fourth values, which are 4 and 6 respectively. In the previous examples, what we had was simple data. Now what we have is a frequency distribution. Frequency distribution is just a table with data values and their corresponding frequencies. Again, we still have to find the median of this set. We have to find the median, which is again number of observations plus 1 upon 2, the position. Now, the only difference is for the number of observations, you'll have to find the total frequency. That's the only difference. So to find the total frequency, I'll just add all the frequencies. Total frequency is called summation F as well. That's just 5 plus 18 plus 11 plus 19 plus 7. This is the total number of observations I have in the set, which we denote by N. So let's add these. 5 plus 18 is 23. 11 plus 19 is 30. Plus 7, 23 plus 30 is going to be 53. 53 plus 7 is 60. So basically, total frequency is 60. N is 60. So the median position is going to be 60 plus 1 upon 2. That's 30.5th. The 30.5th value is the median value. But again, 30.5th is not a natural number. There's no position corresponding to 30.5. So instead, what I'm going to do is I'll take the average of the 30th and the 31st observation. So for which I'll just have to count the values. These are the first 5 values. These are the next 18 values. This adds up to 23. First 5, next 18. Then we have 11 values. From here till here, that adds up to 34. Which means, ki jo 30th or 31st value hai, both are 5. This actually is 5 plus 5 upon 2, which is just 5. So to reach the positions, keep on adding the frequencies. This actually means the first 5 are 2, which is 2, 2, 2, 5 times. Then we have 3, 18 times. So there are 3s, and then there are some 5s, and there are 7s, and so on. So we are trying to find the 30th value. So these are the first 5, next 18, that's 23. Uske baad we'll have the 30th value in this interval, which is 4, 5. And also the 31st value, because 30 and 31 both are less than 34. Now this is again a similar question. We again have a frequency distribution and we have to find the median. But before that, we'll have to find the total frequency first. That's 5 plus 18 plus 11 plus 18 plus 7. This is 23. This is 29. 7. 23 plus 29 is going to be 52. 52 plus 7 is 59. So we have 59 data values in the set. Median position is going to be 59 plus 1 upon 2. That's 60 upon 2, 30th value. So the 30th value itself is the median value. Now again, first 5 values are 2. Next 18 values are 3. That's basically total of 23 values. And next 11 are 5. So basically this goes up till 34. So clearly 30 lies between 23 and 34. So basically 30th value is 5, which is also the median. Now the next average we have is the mode. Mode is the easiest of all. All you have to do is just count the number of observations which are being repeated. Then the one which highest number of repetitions, your highest frequency is the modal value. For instance, I have a set which is 2, 2, 3, 3, 5, 5, 5, 7, 7. So there are some values, all of them are being repeated. But the one with highest frequency, with the highest number of times being repeated is 5. So the modal value is the mode or the modal value. Is just 5. Now one thing here is that there is a possibility that you have multiple modes. For instance, I use the same set but with one additional value. Let's say the set is 2 2 3 3 3 5 5 5 7 7. So now if I look at this set, all values are repeated. There is repetition in every data value. But there are two values with highest frequency of repetitions. And the two values are 3 and 5. So this is a set where you have two modal values. We will not take the average, we will just state these two as the modal values. There are two modes or two modal values which are 3 and 5. We call such sets bimodal. This is just additional terminology. This is additional. What you need to know is how to state the mode. Once again, there can be multiple modes. Okay. Let's take a frequency distribution again. The idea remains the same. You have to identify the value with the highest frequency. If I look at the frequencies, the highest frequency I have is this. This is not the mode. This is the frequency of the modal value. The highest frequency is 19, which is of 7. So the modal value is 7. Mode is 7. The value corresponding to the highest frequency. That's it. One last example. Again, we have to find the mode. Now, if I look at this set, there are two values with highest frequency. The highest value I see in this row is 18, which is here and also here. So, in this case, I have two values with the highest frequency, and the two values are 3 and 7. So this set has two modes, which are 3 and 7.